Hey there, and thanks for watching the TSD, a platform where we think, speak, and discuss. My name is Nyasha Sharon. In previous broadcasts, we've been talking about treatment and managing of cancer. And today we're looking at cancer from a different perspective. As they say, prevention is better than cure. So we're going to be talking about cancer and nutrition. Just what is this nutrition? First of all, we need to realize that there's a very basic diet that has been part of our culture, that has been part of our heritage, and even for Christians, that goes back right to the creation of men. That is the plant-based diet, the Adam and Eve diet. That is the life foods which Robin Sharma referred to in his book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. These are foods that you do not have to slaughter to eat. These are foods that you just go and pick from the garden or pick from your orchard and eat. The less processed, the better. So one, the kind of diet that we need to follow is a plant-based diet. Various kind of vegetables, you know, that we grow in our backyard. This can include your carrots, your peppers, your bread and green peppers, your green vegetables, the spinach, the lettuce, even your beet leaves. You can actually, you know, consume these. You know, the more colorful, the better. That is what adds more nutrients that our bodies need to fight and resist various diseases, including cancer. And then we also need to include other foods such as whole grains, your quinoa, your whole wheat, your heavy breads, you know, the less refined, the better. Your soya beans, your legumes, you know, your tomatoes. These are the kind of foods that our bodies need, not only to nourish, but to fight diseases such as cancer. Many of these foods, such as your vegetables, your green leafy vegetables, they contain vitamin E, which is said to have cancer-fighting properties. And then what do we need to do also? We need to avoid processed foods. We need to avoid foods such as red meats because they're quite heavy on the system. They take too long to digest. And so the longer they sit in the system, the more they fight, you know, or disturb the metabolic system. And just a disclaimer, I'm not a nutrition expert. I'm not a dietitian. I just happen to have researched a number of these things. And so I urge you to see your dietitian, see your nutrition experts, and read the materials that I've posted in the description in the link to this video. So we need to avoid processed foods. What's wrong with processed foods? They put a lot of preservatives so that they last longer on the shelves, you know, because there is no guarantee that the moment they're out of the factory, they're onto your kitchen table. So they put a lot of preservatives. You look at your bacons, your other pork products, they have these nitrites, and nitrites are a definite no-no to the body. So the longer you consume these, the more you disturb your metabolic processes, and the more you then increase your chances of, you know, your cells being attacked, you know, by free radicals that then are likely to put you at increased risk for cancer. So avoid processed foods. Avoid your foods that are high in fats. You know, get the good fats, eat the good fats. When you're cooking, use the good oils, your olive oils and the like. So these are two things so far. We've spoken about the plant-based diet, and we've spoken about them avoiding processed foods and avoiding your red meats, you know, include your white meats, your chicken, your fish. That's better for you, you know, in your diet. And then the third thing, you need to have your fluids that are just right for your body. You know, scientists say our body is made up of 75% of water. So we need to maintain that balance of water in our systems. And we don't maintain that balance by consuming a lot of fizzy drinks, by consuming, you know, a lot of these sodas, and consuming even the so-called 100% fruit juices. They're not quite 100% because the moment they are preserved, there are certain additives that are put in and that have a negative effect, you know, on your nutrition. The kind of nutrients that are put in as these fruits are being processed, they decrease the nutrients. And so they decrease their content, the fresh content, you know, that one should have or should consume within their system. And so what do I recommend? I recommend that we go back to basics. we go back to our traditional foods. You know, Zimbabwe is blessed, you know, as an agricultural economy. And there are many foods that we've abandoned, you know, as we've embraced certain foods that really have a negative impact on our bodies. We have our own foods, our small grains, our rapoko, our millet, you know, our sorghum. Those high starchy foods that are not refined are what is recommended for our bodies. That is what our systems, our body system requires. We have certain fruits or certain foods like your garlic, your onion, your ginger, you know, those are certain foods as well that the body requires and that contain vitamins, you know, your vitamin E, your selenium. Those kind of foods, they contain those nutrients which also help the body in building up the immune system and in fighting carcinogens, you know, in the body. So let's try and go back to basics. Let's grow our vegetables. Let's grow our grains. Let's support our local market. Let's support our local farmers. Let's empower our farming, business and have these foods grown locally and consume, you know, our soya beans. You can even have soy milk. It's actually a better alternative, you know, to the cow's milk. It's got better nutrients and it builds the body and also helps to fight against, these cancer properties that invade the body system. So like I said before, I'm not a cancer expert, I'm not a nutrition expert, but I do have some information that I've come along in my reading path and that I've come along in my own personal experiences. So once again, check the materials posted in the link to the description and let's continue to fight cancer. Let's continue to think, speak, and discuss. And just a reminder, we're broadening the think, speak, discuss platform. It's not all about cancer. As I said in the very first video, we're going to be talking about various issues that affect society. These issues range from personal issues that affect people in their social lives to other current issues, even political issues, just broad subjects that enable you and I to think, that enable you and I to have a good conversation and to reflect on things that happen around us and possibly even to help us to make input into building up our society and being a relevant part of society. So until next time, let's continue to think, speak, and discuss. Cheers.